In this video, we're going to look at four ways to burn and dodge in Photoshop. Now, arguably, it's one of the most valuable tools in Photoshop. As a matter of fact, I'm going to change that. It is the most important tool in Photoshop, in my opinion. Burning and dodging refers to darkening or lightening areas of your image selectively. Now, this technique can be used to enhance your images by creating more three-dimensionality and helping guide your viewer's eye around the photograph. Now, the technique itself derives from the days of film and darkroom printing. It's useful for any genre of photography, and as with many Photoshop tools, there are multiple methods to burn and dodge. Now, I'm going to briefly look at the different ways to burn and dodge in Photoshop and when to use which method, but this is something we cover in far more depth on how to do this in our video tutorials on Carl Taylor Education. So, let's take a look at what burn and dodge actually means. So here on screen you can see two images. One of the images is before any Photoshop work and the other image is after burn and dodge. And the important thing to point out with this image is that there is no Photoshop or comping or cloning or any other work taking place here. This is the raw camera file and then this is the burnt and dodged result. But you can see how much additional impact burning and dodging makes to the final image. So whilst we're not really changing anything significantly within the image, we're only changing tonal values, lightening and darkening selective areas of the image to help guide the eye. But the impact from doing this is profound. Now in this shot of Ophelia, you can see how rather than using techniques to retouch skin and blemishes, the makeup was actually pretty much flawless. Most of the techniques applied to the retouch here are actually burning and dodging. But again, you can see the significant impact that those burning and dodging techniques make to the image. Now in this example, in this fashion image, you can see how important burning and dodging actually becomes to the clothes themselves. Because quite often with fashion photography, clothes will have creases, dents and imprints in them that create shadows and highlights. And we use the technique of burning and dodging to rebalance the shot, remove those highlights or remove those shadows to even things out. And in this example, you can see how effective that is. So what was burning and dodging in the darkroom? Well, the term burning and dodging refers to that darkroom technique used in the printing process for controlling the exposure of a selected area of the image. Now, nowadays, we use a very similar technique in Photoshop, but we have far greater precision with it in Photoshop than we did in the darkroom. Burning refers to the process used to darken certain areas of the image when printing from negatives. This was done by allowing more light to reach a particular area. And this could be done by holding a sheet of cardboard with a hole in it over the area of the print, and it would be positioned to let light through that hole to darken that particular area. Dodging does the opposite of burning. It lightens certain areas of an image. And we do this in the darkroom by holding a piece of card or paper, usually attached to a thin handle, and then light would be blocked from hitting a certain area of the print and therefore brighten that part of the picture. Now, in darkroom printing, that was printing from a negative image. If we're printing from a positive, you'd use the burning and dodging techniques the opposite way round. Now, when do we use burn and dodge? Well, when we take a photo, we essentially create a 2D image. But in order for that image to be aesthetically pleasing, it's important that we make it look as three-dimensional as possible. Now, we can do this by adjusting brightness and contrast in an image. However, using the brightness and contrast adjustments in Photoshop alone can result in a very artificial looking image. This is why burning and dodging is so useful. These techniques allow us to make subtle yet effective effective changes that can change the shape and form of an image. They almost change the lighting within the image. Let's take a look at how effective that can be with this graphic. The images shown here are exactly the same. The only difference is that the image on the right has had burning and dodging applied to it, creating a three-dimensional feel to what is in fact originally a two-dimensional image. Now, they are still both two-dimensional images, but one of them has a very much more three-dimensional appearance to it. Now, you can see exactly how I achieved this in my burning and dodging Photoshop class. But these techniques can be used on any image, and as you can see, are particularly useful when wanting to increase three-dimensionality. Now, using the technique of lightening and darkening selected parts of an image, it's also possible to guide the viewer's eye through the image in the direction you want to. Often retouching in Photoshop, we're retouching to remove blemishes such as pimples, but this doesn't always require the clone or the healing brush tools. In actual fact, many imperfections such as this can instead be fixed or repaired with burning and dodging. Now, depending on your skill level, there are different ways to burn and dodge in Photoshop. Each of these have their own advantages and disadvantages, and you'll have to experiment with each one to find out which works best for you. Here's another great example where I've shot these Beats headphones, and here you can see the raw image, but then you can see how I smooth the tones out in certain areas of the product to create a more pleasing image. So here are four ways you can burn and dodge in Photoshop. The simple method is the burning and dodging tools that are available in the tools menu on the left-hand side of Photoshop. To use these tools, simply select the tool and then set the brush value to the range that you want to use, whether it's on the midtones, the shadows, or the highlights, and select the percentage intensity of the tool itself. Once you've set these, you simply brush over the area you want to lighten or darken. Now, this is a useful technique for those new to Photoshop because it's simple and it's easy to understand. However, I don't tend to use the burn and dodge tools themselves because there are more accurate and effective ways of burning and dodging. One of the disadvantages of actually using the Photoshop burn and dodge tools method is that it's a destructive method of editing. To edit images non-destructively, make sure you work on a new or duplicate layer. This will allow you to go back and alter the changes to an extent as well. Now, option number two is using burn and dodging with curves adjustment layers. Now, this is my preferred method of burning and dodging, as it allows for much greater precision than the burn and dodge tools. And it's also non-destructive because you're working on adjustment layers rather than the actual image. However, it does require a knowledge of using layers and masks. This image requires creating two new curve adjustment layers, one lighter and one darker, and then applying a mask to each of those adjustment layers. After inverting the masks, the brush tool can be used to reveal the lightened curved or the darken curve adjustment through the layer into the image. This method is clearly demonstrated in the Burning and Dodging Photoshop class on carltaylereducation.com. One of the advantages of this method is that you can make an action to create the burn and dodge layers, or you can save yourself even more time and download the actions from our website. It's also a highly precise method of retouching, as not only can you select the brush settings, you can also change the opacity settings of the layer of the adjustment layer after, or even adjust the intensity of the curve once you've created it. The third method of burning and dodging is using selections. Now, this method allows you to make adjustments to very precise areas of an image. Using a selection tool, you simply select the area of the image that you want to edit and you create a new adjustment layer, a new curves adjustment layer. And this, you can then change the amount of the curve according to the effect you want to achieve. So, for example, either brighter or darker by pulling on the curve. Now, as with the previous method, you can also control the opacity of the layer afterwards, and it's a non-destructive method. The fourth method is soft light blend mode. This method involves creating a new layer and selecting either soft light or overlay as the blend mode. Now to do this, go to Layer, New, Layer, and in the New Layer dialog box, select either soft light or overlay blend mode. Once the new layer is created, using the brush tool in either white or black, you can paint over the area that you want to burn or dodge. Again, I don't tend to use this method as I find it much slower than dodging and burning using curves adjustment layers. Now, although Photoshop is the most popular choice of software for adjustments like burning and dodging, you can also achieve similar results using Lightroom's adjustment brush. By painting over areas of the image that you want to change, you can then adjust the exposure, contrast, highlight, shadows, white and black levels, effectively burning and dodging depending on which one you change. Now, regardless of whether you're working in Lightroom or Photoshop, using selections or curves, burn and dodge are the most important techniques for any type of photography retouching. And I hope this video has helped you understand a little bit more about this powerful technique. And remember, you can see exactly how to do this in great detail in our in-depth Photoshop classes on karltayloreducation.com.